Looks like a... It's just like a... Oh. Got him. Totally, totally awesome. Ooh, electric keys. Okay. Now I can hit them, right? Yeah. That doesn't make a lot of sense to me, but... Whatever. Oh, and we're out of the cold area now, so it doesn't even really matter. Oh, we can push these rocks. Where would we want to put? Okay. Hey, there's a hole down there. Can we go golfing? Oh, we can ride on the rocks. I didn't even try that. Get in the hole. Ow, dickhead. Oh, that was a Korok. Cool. Give me that shit. I'm trying to throw rocks in the holes and you assholes are making it difficult. Quit it. It's just like, I'm just gonna move on. Now I live life without a head. Because that's what my life has come to. Where are we on the map, anyway? We're way up here on the edge. Winter Island, Tarm Point, Laudrum Headland. Huh. I kind of want to go back and try and figure out all the shrine quests now. Now that I know that, like, the shrine quest itself is the puzzle and you just get stuff for doing them. It seems like really good stuff, too. Like, these climbing boots? That's what's up. Oh, look, dude, guys, that's a big upgrade. We climb really fast now. Fuck, that's cool. I'm so happy we got that. And I think that the defense trade-off is probably worth it right now. At least right now, you know? Once we find, like, way better defensive stuff, it'll probably be less worth it. What? Oh, I thought that was a monster growling at me. But it was me sliding down the mountain. I just want to come over here and look at this place, because this place looks interesting. I still intend on going back to Kakariko as soon as I'm done screwing around here, but I'm not done screwing around here. Place looks like a Stonehenge-type deal over there. And I don't know how we're going to get to it. This is going to be tricky. I want to grab these shrooms right here. Oh, I can climb like a motherfucker, guys. I think I've gotten lucky so far. Oh, jump back. I'm trying to jump back so I can glide. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, that's a function of the new climbing boots I just got. That's so fucking cool. So they let me kind of, like, slide a little bit. What are these things? No! Nah, they all flew away. I think I've gotten really lucky with the climbing gear that I found so far, because, like, you definitely don't have to find that stuff this early in the game like I have. I figure most people, at the point they're at in the game, would still be just rocking, like, the regular-ass climbing, you know, pretty slow, taking a lot of stamina. But I got some nice upgrades already. Alright, let's go check out Stonehenge. We've come this far. I hope I have the stamina to make it. What I really need is swimming gear. I actually like the climbing. I like the stamina management part of it. Swimming is somewhat less fun, though, just because it's swimming. I've talked about it before. Swimming in video games sucks, guys. It just feels so slow and shitty and cumbersome. And I can't use my extra stamina or else I know I'll never make it. I don't think I'm going to make it anyway. Oh, man. It's going to be close, guys. Oh god. Oh god. I'm not gonna make it. I'm not gonna make it. I'm not gonna make it. No, it's so close. No! Oh, come on. Come on. Oh, I'm sad. I'm sad, guys. How can we make this happen? What can we do to make this better? What the fuck? Oh, it's the rock monsters. What's up, guys? These guys aren't shits, and that's a big ass chew. No, my boomerang broke! Oh, I didn't realize it was so close to not being alive anymore. Oh, fuck off. If you're gonna make me blow you up, at least give me good stuff. Flint and amber's not terrible. Why? I was crouching, man. Sucks. What's that? Something hanging out over here. Oh, it's a bird. How many arrows do I have left? Two. I should probably save them. I don't really need more meat right now, honestly. I've got a ton of meat that I haven't even cooked yet. Well, this place looks a little bit... a little bit closer on this coast right here. You know what, guys? Let's experiment a little bit. Okay, I want to try something. I've noticed that the fire in this game gives you, like an updraft kind of effect. And I wonder if we could use that to our advantage when it comes to gliding. There's so much goddamn stuff in my inventory. It's so hard to find stuff. Here we go, flints. So we're gonna drop wooden flints. Right there. It's gonna fall. Oh, should have been prepared for this. Okay. Well, we wasted a flint. Let's use another one. Okay, I missed. Why did that not start a fire? Because it just started raining. Fuck you, rain! Get out of my life! I'm so sick of the rain in this goddamn game. Ugh. Alright, well... I guess we'll just try this again. I'm not confident. Actually, this looks like it might go a lot better. I think we're a lot closer than we were last time. But we also have enemies. Oh god, oh god. Is that like a water Lizalfos? Dude. Ugh, this is not cool. I can't fight these guys in the water. This is bullshit. I'm gonna have to do another off-camera cooking session really soon. I've got a lot of materials. And I'm running out of, like, the single-use items. Okay. Let's pour the juice on a little bit. I think we can afford it. Fuckers! Dodge. You guys are assholes. There's nothing I can do about this. Let me on! Let me on! Oh, I made it! I made it, guys! But I can't climb up! There we go. Fucking water creatures. I hate the water so much. I'm gonna get you guys for that someday. Not today, but someday. So... Oh man, I think these boots do increase our climbing in the rain, too. Okay, well, we still slip. Okay, it's still difficult. I can't tell if it's any better or not, actually. Yep. Come on. It's not actually all that better. But we made it. So, what's this place? What the fuck is that? Oh my god. Oh my god. You see, okay, okay. You know, we really need to start... categorizing things. Blue-maned Lynel. Oh my god! Lynels are in this game, guys?! Oh shit. He's gonna be strong as shit. I can't do this. Blue-maned Lynel added to compendium. Okay, we'll check that out in a second, but for now... I need to fucking run. Yep. Yeah, okay. Okay. Yeah. Wow. Alrighty. I knew that was gonna happen. So, for those of you who don't know, Lynels were an enemy in the original Legend of Zelda game that lived up in the mountains to the top of the map, and they are strong as fuck. They were, like, one of the most difficult enemies in the entire game. Just in terms of, like, being out in the overworld. They hit really hard, they have a lot of defense. And I don't think they've been in a game since the original. I might not be 100% correct on that. They definitely haven't been in a 3D game. That really surprises me and terrifies me. This is the first time they've been in a 3D game, and they are just... they're awful creatures, guys. They are strong as shit, as you just saw. Kind of sucks. They started me all the way back here, and I lost my entry for him. But, you know, that's okay. We'll get it again sometime. I think now's a good time to actually travel back to Kakariko. Because, holy shit, there's no way I'm going back over there. A few bows fire multiple arrows at once. They offer several times the power of normal bows, while strangely only consuming one arrow at a time. That sounds badass. That sounds like something Long Couch wants. You can run down smaller monsters atop your galloping steed, but don't forget that you cannot make quick turns when traveling this way. Alright. Bottomless Bog, we've read that before. Horse Gates. As your horse's speed increases... okay. Alright, before we get back into Kakariko itself, I want to go back to the ferry and see if we can upgrade any of the stuff that we picked up. Hey, it's another one of those... it's another one of those things. I don't have any really slow-swinging weapons, do I? That sucks. Or any fast-swinging weapons, I should say. Yeah, the last time we ran into this dude, we didn't know what to do with him, and he just disappeared. I'm gonna run up on him and try and stab him now. I guess we're gonna use the torch. It's the only fast-swinging thing I have. Come here, fucker. No! What do you do with those things? I think I tried stealth last time and that didn't work. Oh shit, there he is. Oh, and there's Moohorse. Alright, we'll try stealth again. Nope. Stealth doesn't work. Running at him doesn't work. Fine, we'll fucking shoot him then. If we ever see him again. Stupid... spectral ghostly rabbit. Yay, the fairies are back! Oh, that's so good. I needed that, desperately. I wonder if they just automatically come back once you've used all the ones that you had. Maybe that's the trade-off. That's not bad. You can take them all with you, but at some point, you're gonna use them all and then you have to come back and get, you know, your refills. It's a decent trade-off. Actually, they reloaded my save, so I didn't use that last one that the Lionel took when he killed me. So I should have a fair amount now. Let me see. Hey, I got 4. Not bad. Not bad at all. Oh, woo. Ah, welcome back, boy. Do you want me to enhance your clothing? With the power available to me, I should be able to enhance your clothing a little bit. Which clothing item would you like me to enhance? Definitely my pants. Let's see, they take key swings and rush rooms. Do it. You want me to enhance the climbing boots? Alright, let me do my thing. I hope she brushed her teeth before she did that. Alright. Increase their defense by 1 level, so I guess they're back to what... my other pants were, right? Yes, I know all about set bonuses. Thank you. Okay. So we did pick up some... what were they? Like luminous stones or something that said that they could be used to make clothes? I don't know if the Great Fairy does that or if it's something else. Can't enhance that. We still don't have what we need to do, like, the next tier of upgrades. And we can't do... those either, because they're upgraded once. Okay, I'm just going to do this Hylian Hood since I'm here. I know I neglected to do it last time. I don't know why. It barely takes anything. Might as well just do it. In case I decide to wear it at some point. Yep, that's not possible right now. Please come back here once you get some clothes or materials, or once you've restored the power of my sisters. See you later.
Bye.
Goodbye. So, one of those shrine quests... I'm gonna go into the wrong menu every single time. That one's completed. The Spring of Wisdom. I don't know if the Spring of Wisdom is a great fairy fountain or if it's something else, but we might have to go back there at some point. Somewhere on Mount Lanayru. It's not very specific. So, we'll have to do that once we have a bunch of food to keep us warm, I guess. What up, Moo Horse? Long time no ride. There we go. I was gonna say, I don't know why sometimes I don't get the spurs when I'm trying to ride him. Okay, we're stuck in the tree. We're still learning the mechanics of the horse. Can they go through trees? The answer is no. Okay. He doesn't see her very well either. It's okay, buddy. It's okay. Yeah, you're good. Just walk the way you normally would if you were walking down this trail. That's not exactly right. Okay. Hey, you know what? Let's just glide down there. It is also time for us to pray at this statue and get a heart. First heart upgrade of the game, guys. Let me the fuck out of here. Are you kidding me? You who have conquered the shrines and claimed their spirit orbs. In exchange for 4 spirit orbs, I will amplify your beings. Tell me what it is that you desire. Here we go. I shall grant the power you seek. Yay. Your life force has been strengthened, increasing your maximum number of hearts by 1. That's a very pretty heart container, by the way. Go and bring peace to Hyrule. Alright, there it is, guys. We got a heart upgrade. So the next 2 will be stamina, because that's my plan, and I'm sticking to it. Although, honestly, I wonder if I should amend that now that I have this extra climbing gear. That might not be quite as necessary. Who can say? We'll continue evaluating as we go and see what we feel like, you know. Okay, so... 5 arrows for 20 rupees. Yeah. I'm still trying to save up for that house, but goddamn, I'm so low on arrows, guys. Yeah. I think I will buy some. We can buy 2 bundles. That's not a lot. I'll take them all. So, all of them? That will run you about 40 rupees. How's that sound? Sure.
Ma.
My, eager, aren't we? I'll be sure to make some more for you. And then we could buy them individually, too, I guess? Eh, it's not worth it. That sucks, we only got 10. I mean, I'm grateful that I can buy more, but 10 isn't gonna take us all that far when we're out and about. I can't believe Lynels are in this game, guys. That was fucking horrifying. Like, for real. Oh, this guy's a quest, what's up? Oh, it's you, great timing. I have some news. I did more research regarding the Great Fairy Fountain, and I have a lead. Good, tell me. However, although I know of the spot where it's likely located, it's really hard to get there. I'm not sure I can do it. Even if it's just a picture, I'm dying to see it. Okay, I can take pictures now. Oh, I knew it. I just knew there was someone like you, like me nearby, who appreciates true beauty. Sadly, I can't pin down the exact location of the Great Fairy Fountain. I haven't put it all together yet, but there's a suspicious place I have my eye on. In fact, I was about to head there now. Would you like to come along? Okay? Wait, no, I don't want to go right now, I gotta talk to Impa first. The area beyond that elevated bit of land is suspicious, but why can't I find the Great Fairy Fountain? Are you just talking about that one right up there? Oh, this is a main quest. Wow. Okay, let's go talk to Impa first. Hey, the apples are back on the statues. I'm taking them. Impa, give me my memories. I want them. Huh. I heard Pura was giving you the runaround, but you seem just fine. That's it. We completed the quest. Now then, let me see. Aha! This is, without a doubt, the camera that Princess Zelda used 100 years ago. It's like right in front of the castle. It could be that if you visit the locations within those pictures, you will be able to restore some of your lost memories. No shit, I already knew that. Come back here once you have tried going to at least one of those locations. There is something I wish to give to you. So can I look at them now? Is that okay with you guys? Hyrule Compendium. Oh, it took us right to them. Album. Okay. So it's just here under the album tab. Oh, it's like, it's putting them in with the pictures that I've taken. Okay. Let me see. I don't think it saved the Lionel entry, but I just want to look. Yeah, didn't think so. Okay, so we go straight to album. The layout's a little different now, but now we have them. Let's scroll through these one at a time. That's right in front of Hyrule Castle. That should be relatively easy to find. That's the pass. I forget what it's called, but we know where that is. We went through that place on the way to Kakariko. That should also be relatively easy to find. That place, I really got nothing. There's like a floating island in the sky, or like a giant robot bird or something. Fuck if I know. Can't really tell what that is. Hyrule Castle's there, so that shouldn't be that hard to pin down once we actually get to that perspective. And again, Hyrule Castle will serve as a marker. Might be a little tricky though, finding just the right spot. Okay, there's a bridge and a mountain in the background, two little statues. I bet we could figure that out if we really wanted to. That looks like a castle somewhere. Hard to say for sure. Like, maybe that's in Hyrule Castle? That'd be nuts. Okay, that's a statue in some kind of spring or lake or something. Statue of a horse. I haven't seen that, but once we find it, it should stick out pretty blaringly. That one might be tricky, because there's not a lot to go on. There's an ice mountain in the background, but there's a lot of those in this game. That one's gonna be really hard. There is almost nothing to go on in that picture. It's a freaking forest. There's green stuff everywhere. And that's it. Okay, I'll bet you we could do one of those. Got anything else to say, Impa? You may not remember your last meeting with Ganon, but it did not end well for you. If you want a different outcome this time around, you'll need to be properly equipped. Okay, you got nothing new. I won't fail. She just gives us a look. Princess Zelda is fighting Calamity Ganon all alone. You are the only one who can save her. The only one who can save Hyrule. Now go. You must. Okay. Hey, Paya, got anything new for me? Master Link? Is anything the matter? Anything at all? Can I help you in any way? Nope, you got nothing new either. Okay. So, we've got a bunch of things that we could do now. I'm curious. I think there's a general store in this village that I never entered. That's the clothing shop. Oh, did you get anything new since I bought the old stuff? No, just Hylian tunics. And this stuff's still really expensive. Okay. Where is the damn general store? Oh. When's food? I'm bored. Do you want to play? Yay, what'll it be? Oh, let's play hide and seek. Yay! I'll go hide! Okay, you don't have to Okay. But I've got to go home to Sis when it's dinner time, okay? Cool. I didn't know this was a thing. So we gotta find... Okay, playtime with Katla. Where would a tiny person hide in this village? Under a house? Up in a tree? In a crate? Isn't this like your sister? What should Koko make now? Oh, hot buttered apple sounds good. Mother used to make it all the time. Katla loves it too. Let's see, the ingredients are some apples and goat butter? Oh no, Koko is out of goat butter. Koko is a bad daughter who can't do anything right. Koko will never be like mother. That seems a little harsh. Oh, do I have goat butter? Voila, goat butter. Koko knows when someone is lying. Father isn't good at lying either. Okay, that's getting real. Okay, so I don't have the goat butter. But we got a side quest to... Oh, is this the damn general store? Okay, it's right here. I don't think I've been in here yet. Welcome. Hey, goat butter! Okay, so... Swift carrot, bird egg... Goat butter, we can buy... I guess we could just buy one to give to her. It's 12 rupees. Sure. Thanks. And what do you have to say, Trissa? Do you need something else? Recommendations? Recommendations? Let me think. Well, everything I sell, really. But if you want specifics, there's always Swift carrots. My mister grows them. They put Kakariko Village on the map. Actually, to be honest, there's one other crop Kakariko is known for. Fortified pumpkins. I'd sell them here, but you see, my mister and the pumpkin farmer, they don't exactly get along. So if you want fortified pumpkins, you'll have to get some straight from Olkin's patch. Yeah, he's gonna charge us for them, though. I want to cook. Just put some ingredients into a pot and cook them up good. You can use the one outside if you like, really. I don't mind. Thanks. And, I don't want to sell you anything right now. Do you have recipes on your walls? That would be a smart thing to have in a shop like this, wouldn't it? No. It's weird that we can buy bokoblin guts here, too. They're 80 bucks a pop, though. Holy shit. Yeah, still don't know what they're for. Hey, kid. I got your thing. Koko wants to cook a hot buttered apple, but forgot the goat butter. Koko is a bad daughter who can't do anything. Kid, chill out. I got it for you. Is this? Goat butter? Are you sure about this? Really? Thank you so much. Koko means it. Stay right there for a second. Mmm, what a yummy smell. And that hint of butter makes all the difference. Oh, and the apples are superbly sweet too. Here, take some. It's really something else. Yay, we got a hot buttered apple. The apple's sweetness has been enhanced by smothering it with butter and baking it. That restores 2 hearts. Koko will work hard to get better and better at cooking. Okay. You know what? I want to perform a little bit of science here. I'm curious. Give me one goat butter. No, I'm good. So, a goat butter... Okay, that doesn't do anything on its own. It's kind of like rock salt. You just have to use it with other things. And a regular-ass apple restores 1/2 a heart. So, that ups the healing potential of the apples by 1.5 hearts. That's actually pretty good. Maybe I should buy out all the goat butter. I don't know. We could also just stack the apples together, and we have so many of them that really wouldn't be, you know, such a huge deal. I don't know. That's probably some decisions I'll make, like, when I'm in the act of cooking. Be whatever strikes my fancy, you know? In the meantime, I could jack more and more of these apples. Hey, it's the Plum Garden of Doom. Plums symbolize endurance and prosperity. The way they persevere through the harshness of winter and flower at the first sign of spring. We Shikai strive to live in harmony with our environment and consider plum trees the silent guardians of our village. These plums here were planted by Impa on the day I was born. They're special to me, so I keep a close watch on them. Yeah, you're maybe a little overprotective about the whole plum thing. I get that they're special to you. But, damn, son. I have no idea where to find this kid, guys. there might be a time limit on it, because they specifically mentioned that they would have to go back when it was dinner time. What kind of bow is this? Wooden bow. So, like, I don't know if it's something... Wait, did I just see her run past? Is that her? Dinner time! Dinner time! Yeah, we were too late, I guess. This kid wants more stuff? What should Koko make now? Oh, Koko will make father's favorite. Tough meat stuffed pumpkin. It's great for an energy boost. Let's see, the ingredients are fortified pumpkin and raw meat. Huh? Raw meat? Oh no! Koko is out of raw meat. Koko could use a different kind of meat, but without raw meat, Koko can't recreate mother's recipe. Father used to go hunting to make sure we always had raw meat, but he's at work right now. Koko is a bad daughter who can't do anything right. Jesus, this kid. Just take the raw meat. Is this... raw meat? Are you sure about this? Really? Thank you so much. Koko means it. Stay right there for a second. Yeah, this damn kid wants to cook so much stuff, but she just doesn't plan ahead. What would she do if I wasn't here? Mmm, what a scrumptious smell. Oh, and that savory meat pairs so well with the sweetness of the pumpkin. This is just how Mother made it. Here, have some. It's so good. Tough meat stuffed pumpkin restores 3 hearts and grants a low-level defense boost. Okay, good. Koko will work hard to get better and better at cooking. Awesome. I should probably make another one of those, because I like defense boosting items, and I think I have another pumpkin, don't I? Yeah. Let's go ahead and toss that in with some... do we want... Yeah, we just want regular raw meat, probably, for now. So we will go ahead and cook that shit up. Badass. What should Koko make for dessert? Oh, Koko will cook a honeyed apple. Mother love those. It melts in your mouth and is so delicious. Let's see, the ingredients are an apple and coarser bee honey. Of course, you don't have the shit you need, though. I get it. I wonder how many of these food quests there are for this girl. Koko wanted to make some for Mother in Heaven, but Koko is a bad daughter. Jesus, this is some seriously messed up shit this girl's saying. Here. Wait, is this... coarser bee honey? Are you sure about this? Really? Thank you so much. Okay. I mean, it's worth it because we're still getting the recipes from it, and we're getting the actual food items. This is... Koko remembers. When Koko had a fever, Mother would always cook this just for Koko. When Mother made her special dessert, she always put some of this in it. Oh, Mother. Koko. Oh, Koko. We'll do her best and try and be as good as you one day. Koko will get better and better. Koko promises. Koko was able to recreate Mother's dishes. Koko feels better now. It's all thanks to you. Please take this. Ooh, energizing honeyed apple. 5 hearts and stamina. Wow. That's a pretty good item. I'll have to remember that. Apples and honey. Just a good, like, all-purpose, get-your-shit-back-together item. Alright, it sounded like that was the last one, but let's talk to her. Oh, it's you! Koko has made a decision. Koko will become a chef when Koko grows up. That way, Koko can make everyone happy with yummy food. This whole time, Koko has been relying on Mother's recipes. But from now on, Koko will come up with her own recipes, too. To be honest, coming up with recipes is hard. Yeah, I agree. And you never know what you're gonna get. It might be something good, or it might be some bullshit. Dubious food, and then you just wasted stuff. Yeah. That's my biggest bane, guys. I hate feeling like I wasted stuff. Even if it doesn't matter in the slightest. Well, I'll tell you guys what. I am going to run out this way. I'm not sure what I want to do from here. There's a lot of things on our... docket that we should try and get done. And, you know what I kind of want to do? I kind of want to go try and find the, what was his name? Hestu, I think, was his name. Fucking, why do I always leave it on the torch? Why do I do that every time? Back here, shithead. Couldn't quite make it. has to, I think, so that we can finally upgrade our inventory slots. Sorry, I'm having trouble talking and concentrating right now. Don't know why. But, yeah. He said he was going to go into Korok Forest, and he told us generally where that was. But I think it's a place we have to go and find. And I don't think we're actually anywhere close to it right now. Let me see. We found him. Jesus, this place is so freaking big. That's probably a shrine that I marked at some point. Okay, we found him on the road to Kakariko. New horse? We should be close enough for him to come, right? He said we had to follow the road, like, up Laneru River, I think, and head to the north from where we were when we first found him. Which means it's gonna be... Seriously? You know, maybe I will go try and find... a new horse. Moo horse is fine, but he doesn't listen super great. And I think he's pretty low stat compared to some other horses. Okay, I think this is about where we found him, right? Because back here were the bokoblins that we had to go take out to get his maracas back. Yes. And they're back now. I don't really need to fight them. They're gonna chase me for a little bit. That's okay. Seriously, fucker? You wanna do this? Do you really wanna do this? I don't really want to waste any of my weapons on you. There. Are you happy now? You made me break my silver longsword, you dick. Okay, so... He was standing right around here. He said... Follow... Oh, Moo Horse, you did make it. The game lied to me.